Hello students, welcome back to your science class. So student, in the previous class we were talking about that of the biogeochemical cycle. Here in this chapter, that is biogeochemical cycle, we were discussing about the different cycles, students. It will include the biotic component, it will include the abiotic component, or we can say the interaction between that of the biotic and abiotic component, that is a biogeochemical cycle, okay, which we called as a water cycle, abiotic biotic cycle. Now see here, if we talk about the biogeochemical cycle, in this chapter we will going to study the four different type of a biogeochemical cycle. The first one is the water cycle, and we have understood about that of the water cycle, students. So talking about the water cycle, it will include the first method, and that is evaporation. And in the process of evaporation, you see that there are sunlight, and the sunlight will help in evaporating that of water into water vapor. And then the when the water vaporizes from that of the surface water, it will evaporate in the air, and the process of transpiration and respiration also take part in it. And afterward, these all water vapor, when reaches to a higher altitude, there the temperature is low, and it will get condenses. So condensation process occurred, and then cloud formation, because the water vapor get converted into water droplets, and droplets converted to water drops, and ultimately the cloud become heavier and the rainfall occur. That process is called as a precipitation reaction. Now through the precipitation reaction, the water reaches to the groundwater, ground level, and it will be precipitated at ground in the form of a groundwater, underground water, where it will be stored and used as a fresh water. The next type of a cycle that we were talking is the nitrogen cycle. In case of a nitrogen cycle, okay, so the nitrogen which is present in that of the atmosphere, and you see in the cycle itself, we know that the nitrogen, the percentage of the nitrogen is what? It is 78%, which is the highest percentage of a gas which is present in that of the atmosphere. Now this nitrogen, it will be fixed with the help of the nitrogen fixing bacteria. And this nitrogen fixing bacteria, it will convert that of the nitrogen into the nitrate. And these bacteria are basically present in that of the leguminous plant and called as a nitrate or nitrite, and there it will be again reaches to that of the soil. There are some other factor also which are responsible for the conversion of the nitrogen to nitrate, and it will include the lightening process in which the nitrogen get converted into nitrate or nitrite. Now you can see here, so as you can see, the first one is the nitrogen fixation, students. So nitrogen fixation will occur with the help of nitrogen fixing bacteria. And then you will find that these nitrogen fixing bacteria, it will present in the root nodule of the leguminous plants, and yes, we can say that is in the green plant. Now the plants, they used to take up this nitrate and convert it into amino acid, and through amino acid it will be converted into protein. Now this is the complex form of a nitrogen. Again, it will be used by that of the animals. So we can say here that now the nitrogen is transferred from the plants to that of the animals. Okay, now the animals, they use this and convert itself into that of the ammonia. So what happened, how this ammonia occur? Now you see here, from the green plant ammonia formation occur, and from the animal also the ammonia formation occur. So in both of the cases, how ammonia occurs, students? So basically through the process of ammonification. And here we can say that due to the death or even through the excreta which is released by that of animal or by plants, it will be present in the form of ammonia and atmosphere. Now this ammonia, again it is converted to nitrite and then nitrate, And yes, again with the help of the ammonification process, ammonia will be formed, and again with the help of a nitrifying bacteria, it will be converted to nitrate and nitrite. And this nitrate is again used by the plant. This is one of the cycle in which goes on and on in the nature. Okay, so the urea or the death of the plant and animal will help in the release of this nitrate and nitrite into the soil again, and the soil again become rich to the nitrate, and which will be again used by the next leguminous crop. Now, sometime what happened that in the soil there are some of the denitrifying bacteria are present, and these denitrifying bacteria help in converting the nitrate into the nitrogen, into the free nitrogen into the atmosphere. So, nitrification is a method in which the nitrogen get converted into nitrate, and again denitrification is that process in which the nitrate get converted into free nitrogen in the atmosphere. So this is how the whole process of the nitrogen take place or revolve into the atmosphere. Okay, so this is called as the nitrogen cycle. As you can see here at the last, you will find that there atmospheric and industrial fixation is also there. Yes, you can see that lightening is also one of the method by which the process of the fixation take place. Even there are a lot of different compounds which is prepared in that of the industries and used in the form of a fertilizers, in the form of a manures. It is used into the soil where it will help in providing the sufficient nitrogen to that of the plant, which will get converted into amino acid or that of protein. Okay, so this is how the process of the nitrogen occur, process of the nitrogen in the atmosphere easily occur. Okay, now let us move on and see the another kind of a cycle, which is called as a carbon cycle. Talking about carbon, you know, carbon is also a very important. Our body, it is consisting of a carbon a lot. The elemental form of a carbon, if we talk, so that is graphite and diamond. If we talk about the combined state, see, when we talk about the elemental form and when we talk about the combined form, there is a difference. Elemental form, it is, we are talking about the free state of that of the carbon. Means carbon can occur in the atmosphere in the form of a diamond or in the form of a graphite, where the amount of a carbon is really high. Although when we go to the higher section, we will come to know about this, that is why these are also called as allotrope of carbon. It means it is found in a different form in the atmosphere. Okay, diamond and graphite both. Now, diamond, graphite, as well as there is another, that is Buckminster fullerene, which is also exist in nature in the form of an allotrope. Okay. If we talk about a combined state, so in the combined state, it is found as a carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, okay, as a carbonate, as well as a hydrogen carbonate salt in the various minerals, which is, we can say that's a very important life form for all the living organism. Like, if we talk about the carbon-containing molecule, student, protein, carbohydrate, fats, these all are what is consisting of a carbon only. So what is these? These all are the different ways by which different nutrient and mineral through which we get the carbon, and we have understood that what is the importance of the carbon to us. Now see here, nucleic acid, vitamins, these all consisting of a carbon only. You see students, in case of aquatic animal especially, the aquatic animal which consisting of an exoskeleton, and us consisting of the endoskeleton. So endoskeleton and exoskeleton of many animals, they are form of a salt, and that salt is called as carbonate salt. Now carbonate is what? That is also made up of a carbon only. Okay, so carbon help in the formation of a carbonate, or we can say that carbonate salt is there, which will be used up, and it will help in providing the carbon to the animals. Now carbon is what? It is incorporated in the process of the photosynthesis. You see that when the sunlight occur. So the leaves of the plant it consisting of the chlorophyll in it, and the chlorophyll help in trapping that of the sunlight. Now the carbon dioxide and the oxygen, carbon dioxide and that of the water, it will combine together to it will help in the formation of that of the glucose. Now this glucose molecule is what? It is also a carbon molecule consisting of a carbon in it. Okay, now this glucose will be used up by that of the living organism in the form of a respiration. It will help in providing the energy to that of the living things, right? So again this glucose is used up by the living organism, and ultimately it will be broken down, and there is a release of a carbon dioxide and the water. So this carbon dioxide which was used up by the plant in the process of the photosynthesis, it will again released into the atmosphere. Okay, it will be released into the atmosphere through the process of a respiration. So by the process of a photosynthesis it was used up, and by the process of a respiration it was again released into the atmosphere. There is another process also, students, by which the carbon dioxide is present in the atmosphere, or it is the carbon dioxide is released into that of the atmosphere, and that is the process of combustion. In the process of the combustion, where fuels are there, so these fuels are burnt to provide energy for various needs like heating, cooking, transportation and industrial processes. Okay, so different domestic fuels which we use, it help in providing the energy, and that energy is used up in a different processes that we used to do in our day-to-day life. Okay. So not only this, the carbon dioxide, the carbon which is present in our body, have you ever thought that how this fuel consisting of a carbon in it, if we talk about coal, if we talk about petrol, these all are made up of a living organism, dead plant and the animals, when they get compressed and under the pressure, high pressure and high temperature, in the absence of oxygen, after millennia it will be converted into that of the fuel. So ultimately it is made up of the plant and animal, and this plant and animal, it means the body consisting of a carbon in it. Okay, so the fuel which is made here, it is also consisting of a carbon content. So if we talk about the water itself, like water, the carbon is what? It is cycled into the nature. Now let us see what is that of the carbon cycle. So the same thing, the first one, as you can see here, CO2 in the atmosphere. Now this CO2 in the atmosphere is present, carbon dioxide, it is present in a very less amount, even less than that of the one % Okay, and this carbon dioxide, it will be used by the plant. So that's why it is written here, the first one, it is the plant. Okay, now plants, they through the process of a photosynthesis used by the plant, and through the process of a respiration, the glucose which is formed in the plant, it will be used by the animal. Now again through the process of a respiration and even through the process of a decomposition, it will be again released into the atmosphere. Sometimes the plants also do the plant used to perform the process of photosynthesis, as well as it is also responsible for carrying out the process of a respiration. So the plants, they used up this carbon dioxide in the process of photosynthesis, and when glucose is there, it with the help of oxygen, it will be broken down into the carbon dioxide again. That's why it is written here that the first one is the process of photosynthesis, through which the plant is take the carbon dioxide, but through the process of respiration it will again released into the atmosphere. Now what happened? There are some other method also. Carbon dioxide present in that of the atmosphere, it will be used up in the carbonate. It is present in the shells of the exo or the endoskeleton of that of the carbonate in the water. Now it will be also used up in making that of the limestone. So you have heard about, especially in case of a aquatic animal or in case of a sea or ocean, that there are lot of a limestones are present. So this basically be present, this basically will made with the help of the carbon dioxide. Okay. Now some the plants, when they get dye, they get converted into coal. Now the plants also get converted into the petrol. Similar with that of the animal, when dye, they get converted into that of the petroleum. And I told you that the shells of the animals, they are also made up of inorganic carbonate ion, calcium carbonate, like calcium carbonate, that it will help in making the shell of the animal. So this is how the carbon dioxide is distributed to the different element, and this is how the use of the carbon dioxide, even though their percentage remains the same, because it keeps on released, used up as well as released into the atmosphere. Okay, so this is about that of the carbon dioxide. There is a very important term here, student, greenhouse effect. Now let us try to understand about the greenhouse effect. See, here the term is greenhouse effect. When we talk about the greenhouse, so first of all, we must know what is the meaning of a greenhouse. You look, students, if especially in that of a cold climate, there are houses, there are the plants, because of a very low temperature, they are not able to survive, they are not able to grow properly. So in order to grow such kind of a plant, which need a normal temperature or which need a warm temperature, the people, they living in that of the cold climate, they used to prepare, they used to make a house like that. Now, what kind of a house it will be? A house which is made up of a glass. Now, what is the property of a glass which make it more special to make it as a house for the plants? Actually, the glass, there it is having a property that it will allow that of the light to enter into it, but it do not allow the light to exit from that of it. Okay, so if a compartment or if a room which is made up of a glass, so when the sunlight passes through it, it will trap the heat, but do not allow the heat to reflect back again. So this property will help in the making that of the house, and since this house is made to for the growth of the plant, that's why it is called as the greenhouse. Okay, so you can see here it is written that heat is trapped by the glass, and hence the temperature inside a glass enclosure will be much higher than that of the surrounding. Okay, this phenomena was to create an enclosure where the tropical plants are there. Basically, we can say there that the glass is there which will help in trapping that of the heat. So the temperature inside to that of the glass, it will be increases than that of surrounding, and obviously when the temperature increases, it will help in keeping the environment inside it warm. Okay, so during winter, it will help in keeping the warm, and such an enclosure is called as a greenhouse. So greenhouse, this process, this is also present in that of the nature. It is also a kind of a natural phenomenon, and it is about that of our earth atmosphere. So our earth atmosphere, you see that there are gases which present in the atmosphere which help in preventing the heat to reflect back from that of the atmosphere. Okay, so basically what happened when the sunlight falls on it, enter into the earth atmosphere, the gases, there are some of the gases like especially carbon dioxide is there, methane is there, water vapor is there. These are some of them which do not allow the heat, reflect back to the atmosphere. Basically, it will help, or we can say that it will help in trapping that of the sunlight, the heat which is falling into the earth atmosphere. So what happened? Now, when the percentage, now these gases are really important, student. Why?
These gases are important as these help in maintaining the temperature. Otherwise, what will happen? It will leads to increase in the temperature, right? So, in order to prevent the colder climate, which is dangerous for the survival. So, in order to prevent it, these gases are really important as it will help in maintaining the temperature. But again, the problem is that if the percentage of these gases increases, then there is a chance of the prevention. Some of the gases are not able to escape themselves. And ultimately, the temperature will increases a lot. And when there is an increase in the temperature, this effect, which is caused due to that of the greenhouse gases, are called as a greenhouse effect. So the gases which is responsible for causing or for increasing the temperature, they are called as a greenhouse gases. And out of that, carbon dioxide is one of the greenhouse gas which is responsible for increasing the temperature, increasing the heat into the atmosphere, and ultimately this will leads to that of the global warming. Okay, so percentage such as gases is there in the atmosphere, it will help in increasing the average temperature, and due to the increase in the average temperature, this effect is called as the greenhouse effect, student. Okay, now we can say here that what kind of a consequences will be there to that of the greenhouse effect. So basically, increase in the carbon dioxide will increases the atmosphere, and ultimately it will leads to the global warming. Global is the our earth, and warming, that the warm or the increase in the temperature which occur because of the greenhouse gases. So greenhouse effect leads to that of the global warming. Okay, what are the different names of the greenhouse gases, students? So carbon dioxide is one of them, then methane is there, then water vapor is there. These all are responsible for trapping that of the sunlight. So that's why they are called as the greenhouse gases, and they all lead to the global warming. Okay, what is the result? What is the consequences of that of the global warming? So obviously, the consequences of the global warming will be what? Melting of the glacier will be one of the consequences which will occur due to the global warming, students. Now let us move on and see that of the oxygen cycle and that of the ozone layer. So if we talk about the oxygen cycle, student, as you can look at here, so oxygen cycle is what? You know that atmospheric oxygen is present in our atmosphere. Oxygen is 21% of oxygen is present, and we uses the oxygen to breathe, obviously for the process of respiration. So the first process here involved is respiration, and through which water is released as well as carbon dioxide is released, and both of them will be used up in the process of photosynthesis, and again the process of photosynthesis help in the formation of a glucose, which is an organic molecule, and it will also help in releasing that of atmospheric oxygen. Now this whole process, the process of respiration photosynthesis keeps on going and help in maintaining the amount of oxygen into the atmosphere. Okay, so this is that of the oxygen cycle. The next one, if you see here, that is the ozone depletion. Now let us try to understand about that of the ozone depletion. You know, our earth is covered with a very protective layer, which is of ozone layer. And what is the use of this ozone layer? So this ozone layer help in protecting us from a harmful radiation, that is the ultraviolet radiation, which can cause a cancer or the skin diseases to the person. So it basically help in preventing, do not allow the ultraviolet radiation to enter into the earth's surface. Now, what happened due to the continuous use of the substances which releases CFC gas, chlorofluorocarbon gas, which is responsible for breaking off the ozone layer, depleting the ozone layer, and this is called as a ozone depletion. Even if you look into the Antarctica results said that the ozone layer become this much thin that there is a hole which is formed there, which we call as a ozone hole. So this ozone layer, it is depleted, it become thinner because of the release of aerosols, the perfume that we use, the refrigerator gas, this all consisting of a CFC, chlorofluorocarbon, which is responsible for the breaking of that of the ozone molecule into oxygen and O, and ultimately the ozone layer breaks or ozone layer depletes. Okay, so this is called as ozone depletion.